Hello, I'm Jürgen Bellmann from Sophistic. In this video, I want to show you some advanced possibilities in the Teddy text input. In the first video, I explained the basic features of Teddy on this example, and we will continue on this now. This was the original input for the four notes, and you see this height 4.2 is used twice, and maybe in your input file you use it 100 times. So you can define a variable let height 420. You keep in mind it's in meter, and we can use this variable here and here, and the same for the dx, the span width. It is best to add the dimension here, then you can also read it much better. We have variables let and store. The difference is the let is only valid in this module, but if you store the variable, you can use it also in the next Sophie load. Maybe here for the wind loading, depending on the square root of the height. If you use store, it is not necessary that you use let in advance, so this is enough. We see we get the same system. We now want to extend our system for more spans. In the input we now need more than four nodes. And you can use inside loops for this. Maybe we say we need nodes number 101 up to 106 in an increment of 1, so we create 6 nodes. The first node has the x ordinate 0, and the next will always be increased by a difference, and this we store here by 5 meter. The same for the upper nodes on set equal 4. Of course, on the beam elements we have to do the same. We now run the system and get this result. You see we have 6 columns and 5 spans. We now go to our next input and make real loops. We say we have 5 spans. This is a store variable, and we can make a loop on spans plus 1, that is 6, because we need 6 columns. We can insert a loop variable hash e0 that will start with the value of 0 and will be increased in every step, so it goes up to 5 only. Therefore, I always insert a variable hash e1 that will be increased by 1, so we have our variables 1 to 6. Now we insert our first node that will be 100 plus 1, because in the first loop this has the value 1, so node 101, and we'll get the x coordinate hash e0, that is 0 in the first loop, multiplied with the x. And in the second loop it will all be increased by 1. For the beams I here used the other technique where I said I want to insert a beam from 101 to 100 plus 5 plus 1, that is 106, so from 101 to 106. If I run this, I get the same result, but I now change the number of spans maybe to 15. I run it and go into the animator, and we see now we have 15 spans. As we have stored our n-spans variable in Sophie Mesh A, we can also use it in Sophie Load. I first want to show you what I want to achieve. I want 200 kilonewton on every column, but on the first and on the last only 100. I write a loop over the number of spans plus 1, that means over the number of columns. I again set my E1 variable to go from 1 to 6. Then I make a if condition. If E1 is equal 1 means the first column, I apply 100 kilonewton. If E1 is the last column, also 100 kilonewton, and else I apply 200 kilonewton. So I get this picture. Now we go to the next possibility I often use, that is a paper strip. I can define a block 1 from here to end def, including these three lines. These three lines are now like on a paper strip, and whenever I include this block, I include this paper strip. In the first load case, I define the x-coordinate to 12.5 and use this x-coordinate for the point loading. In the next load case, I only change the x-value to another value and insert the same paper strip. If we look to WinGraph, we can now see load case 911, 12 and 13. For the next feature I want to show you, I switch to this bigger system with SOFI Plus, and I now want to make a nonlinear cracked analysis, sysprop non-L. NMAT yes means that the quads are calculated nonlinear with cracked concrete. I set a load case with factor of dead load 1. I take the live load only by 50% and load case copy. Copy the loads of load case 2 and 3 into this new load case 301. If I now start this calculation, ASE is running, but you see I cannot do anything. I cannot even go into the Teddy and look what should I do for the next analysis. This, I think, is not very fine, so I always save all tasks as a Teddy file. OK. And if I go to the Explorer, look for the changing date, I will see my file externteddy.dat here and open it. If I go to the end, I really find my input for the nonlinear ASE run here. I now switch off all parts, only activate the last proc ASE with this button here. And if I now calculate this ASE run, ASE is running, you see it, and in parallel I can go into my Teddy and change something. Maybe prepare for the next load case 302 with 70% live load. I now change to the analysis part, wait until the last load case is finished. I can just start the next load case. Also, this is very comfortable to study what would be if. I copy with Ctrl C and Ctrl V this information and now make a load case 309 where I change the concrete tensile strength maybe to 1.5 only. If I made changes here in this Teddy, they are not automatically updated in the SSD. So I use again Ctrl C, go to my SSD, into my input file, and now of course I can input this information that I have edited before. Now, what happened? Let's say our project has the name Munich. We started in SSD, used our SOFI Plus munich.dwg and run our system. Then we go to File, Save all tasks as text to make this text file munich.dat. And from this text file, if we run this text file, we can now also access to the same database munich.cdb. My last feature I want to show you today is you can use the main Munich database for your SOFI Plus input. Then you create the Teddy file, and this Teddy file you now give another name, variant 2 maybe. Here with this command in the first Teddy line, plus sys copy munich.cdb to name.cdb, name is automatically replaced by the name of the file, here vary2. So this makes a real copy of this database to the database vary2.cdb, and if you now run this Teddy, you are only accessing and changing this database variant 2, and of course you can also make a variant 3, 4, 5, whatever you want to do, and in parallel you can go into your Sophie Plus and change your system in your base file munich.cdb. But this, I would say, is only a possibility for experts.
So thanks for listening and goodbye!